बिस्मिल्लाहिर्रहमानिर्रहीम अस्सलामु अलैकुम वरहमतुल्लाहि वबरकातुहू। नमस्कारम वणक्कम। माय नेम इज नफील। आई कम फ्रॉम श्रीलंका एंड इट गिव्स मी ग्रेट प्लेजर टू बी हियर ऑन दिस डे ऑफ प्रोग्रेस। डियर पार्टनर्स इन प्रोग्रेस, अप ऑन द स्टेज and down on those chairs in the auditorium, distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen, I welcome you all to this very productive new venture into your life. It is very funny that our country Sri Lanka has been dealing with this agarwood for last 400 odd years. India has progressed much faster, though they started very late, like in the Ayurvedic industry too. If you take Ayurvedic, I think we have, Sri Lanka has the capacity and inventions and knowledge, but the best people, you know, those who benefited by that, those who marketed that, those who brought that out to the world is from India, especially Kerala. Likewise, as I said, we have been dealing with agarwood for more than 440 years, whereas I understand in Kerala it is prevalent for last 20-30 years, and in Assam I think it is for last 4-5 years, where you have the highest stock in existence. It is true that even in Sri Lanka, lot of people, they cut the trees without knowing that it is agarwood. Actually, the knowledge of agarwood was not public to people because they have been dealing with only through limited channels in a silent mode, so that nobody knew what it was. It seems that the Arabs came to Sri Lanka for trading originally for agarwood, not for spices as it is mentioned earlier, because people believe the Arabs came to this part of the world, even Kerala as well as Sri Lanka, for spices, whereas originally they have come for agarwood. And at least now Dr. Samsudeen, who has opened up this for you and me, for the whole world, the opportunity that is provided in introducing this plant to you all to change your future, to change your prosperity, to bring in wealth for you and for the not so well to do. Actually, I was invited in 2014 in this village. I was the chief guest in a function where I spoke about poverty alleviation with regard to agarwood and how it can work. Though I have said about those things, I will have to repeat few things so that for the newcomers it will be a good knowledge and it will be a good input, so that you can advise others as to how you can benefit and how you can build up, how you can improve on your social economic, and which becomes a device to improve our life. I would start with talking about socio-economic impact. And possibility of agarwood. Actually speaking, originally everybody thought that this can be grown only in rain-fed area, which is not really correct. In my opinion, it could be grown anywhere. If you make the conducive environment, you can grow anywhere in this part of the world. And you don't need to be reluctant to start up a venture or even to try out. Actually speaking, the government of India or the state of Kerala, the government agricultural sector can definitely facilitate for the poor masses either under a subsidy or in any other form to connect the industry and the poor masses so that everybody can benefit by planting agarwood. You see, planting agarwood is the most easiest thing in the whole process. Anybody can plant agarwood. If you have the basic intelligence and the planting material, you can grow agarwood without any problem. But doing the inoculation, that is to introduce the fungus into the tree, it is a technical input which is critical for the end results. But fortunately, that could be done by AWK, that is Agarwood Kerala. Dr. Samsudin has spent this part of his life, more than 20 years, doing his own research while getting the help of the department, government sector researchers. You can see we have a botanist, Dr. Radhakrishnan here, a director from department, Mr. Josh is here, Dr. Swami is there. Obviously, it is an investment that you have to make. Another alternative is for Ms. Dr. Samsudin to approach the poor farmers and give them, say, 2 plants each individually and sign a contract with them to buy it back, right? If the farmers, the poor farmers, wants to do further, and if they have more space, they can even pay and buy in addition to the 2 plants. So what happens is the wealth is spread, and even for poor farmer, looking after 2 plants won't be a major problem. Definitely, you have ground, close groundwater, whereas, you know, it is more than enough for you to look after the plants. So that is another alternative that could be looked at. When you have a female child, when a female child is born, this could be an investment for the future of the female child. By the time she is old, you know, it is going to be an investment for the education of the child. Another aspect of the benefit of this planting agarwood, you see, we have a major social problem in many families when the mothers are sent out to Saudi Arabia for laboring there. As laborers, our ladies are sent to Saudi Arabia due to poverty. If they can look after 2 or 3 agarwood plants, they can come out of their poverty. The impact is two-sided. One is, when they go, the children doesn't have a mother to look after the children. And that creates a lot of problem, because a father alone cannot look after a child the way the mother can look after. That is very obvious. We can argue, we can say anything, but the truth is very bitter. And also it creates a lot of problem, because father can go on the wrong way, going behind, you know, other women and partners. This is a major problem in this part of the world, not only in India, even in Sri Lanka it is the same. So to overcome that, this will be a good investment and a good pathway, because end of the day it is the economical disparity that creates lot of social problem in our societies. Let it be, whether it is Muslim or Hindu or Christian, it is the same. Problem is one and the same. So we have to face it, and I think Dr. Samsudin's activities really can take care of some of these social problems that can help you in a way that future we will have hope. All of us really live on hopes. If not for hope, a lot of people would have committed suicide. So it is that the hope that gives you your future expectations, and that religion is the main thing that guides you to have your hopes. Next thing I would like to touch, because there are so many knowledgeable, you know, speakers waiting to give you a lot of explanations. Whatever I skip or I forget, maybe you can ask us, you know, at the end of the workshop. Also, the others will definitely cover the topics that is beneath my being. Agarwood, like I said, planting is not an issue. You only have to dig, say, 40 centimeters by 40 centimeters by 40 centimeters a pit. You know, I'm just giving you the overall idea. Dig the pit, put those soil aside, scrape all the topsoil right round, fill the pit. It should be filled with topsoil, and you will have your small packet. To that size, you dig a small hole and plant the tree into that. And in general term, no care is the best care for agarwood. You see, when it is very valuable, when you know the return is big, your idea of like spoiling a child, you know, you want to take care of it too much. That can kill the tree, that can kill the plant. So therefore, you don't need to give any extra care for the plant. Average care or no care is better for the plant. But one thing for sure, you have to water the plant. If it is a dry area, definitely you have to water the plant. You can worry for 1 year, 1.5 years. After that, if it is very dry area, you have to definitely water. If not, you can just leave it, because plant grows on its own. And people have misconception about agarwood. Somebody asked me whether Akhil is also agarwood. Akhil is a fragrance plant similar to sandalwood, or maybe same family. The scientists have to answer that. It is similar to that, but you know, they say when you extract oil from that, it is also like agarwood. Maybe you can get oil, but it is not the same. The difference in between the leaves, Akhil leaf is not sharp, it is rounded. And sandalwood is, it is different from Akhil. And don't mistake Akhil for agarwood. Maybe it is the finding of the adulterators. Adulterators, those who want to make extra money, they take the shortcut. Maybe they mix all the fragrance, and they try to show that it is a new variety or whatever. Like, so don't get misled by thinking that agil is same, one and the same, like agarwood. The simplicity of cultivation of agarwood, unlike other plants, say if you plant any other forestry plants like mahogany or rubber or anything else, coconut, you have to have extra care. Definitely you have to have extra care. But for this, you don't need extra care, though it is giving you best return. Once it is matured, you don't need to have extra care. Only thing, there are approaches, things like pruning the tree so that the stem becomes big. Pruning the tree, I have little different opinion. Like most of the scientists will say that when you are pruning, the stem is going to grow big, and that is very suitable, so your yield will be big. But my suggestion to you all, when you are pruning, I would say you do air layering and make more plants. So that is also while you are pruning, but you are having extra plants also. When you prune, you throw the branch. By way of air layering, you can multiply, because those branches will have a biological age. Let's say that you are pruning a 3-year-old plant. What happens when you do air layering? The branch also has 3-year biological age. When you plant it on the ground, it is, the tendency is that it will try to catch up the biological age. So that means, for instance, you know, we saw a 3-year-old plant at Dr. Samsudin's research station. I saw that plant, you know, maybe you can make about 30 small plants if you do pruning by way of air layering. So when you do air layering, within 6 weeks, you know, you will have roots in that branch. You cut it and plant it in a small packet, right, pouch. And afterwards, after another 6 weeks, you plant it on the ground. So that means you have a matured big plant. You don't need to sit and waste your time for 1 year or 1.5 years. That means you are saving time. Because when people have few plants, and when you want to plant a new plantation, then, you know, best thing is when you are pruning, you multiply your plants. And that will be an additional advantage. Maybe our researchers and scientists have a different opinion. Most welcome to educate me, and I'll be delighted to learn from you all. And as you know, Dr. Samsudin has done enough of research in order to face the challenges, to experience the challenges, and to educate others when there are questions. Because, you know, nobody can make tasty food looking at the cookery book. You see, you need to have experience. Likewise, you know, 5 years back, I never told anybody about air layering until I did myself and I saw that was successful. That is why I'm talking to you today. So that is another way of multiplying. So with the experience of Dr. Samsudin, definitely you have answers to all your problems. Without any problem, you know, you can go ahead. And if you have any problem, you can, that could be sorted out also. So be positive, and you go ahead with your whatever the program that you want to start up. And I also have to tell the other side of, we have been talking all about the good things of agarwood. Agarwood cannot be planted on a land that is waterlogged. It will die in 3 days. If there is water around the plant, stagnant water around the plant, it will die in 3 days without any hesitation. So please, you should have proper drainage. On a hill slope and all, planting is not a problem because water will never stay. Right? So the other thing is, agarwood plant is very susceptible for pest and disease. One of the common thing that we have noticed is caterpillar attack. You know the caterpillar? In Tamil they call it masukutti. What do you say caterpillar in caterpillar, the insect that eats yeah. Yeah, yeah, left up, right, right. So, suddenly overnight, left up, yeah. You know, overnight, it can eat all the leaves. You will see the vein of all the leaves, but the green part won't be there. You know, it will be missing. So, it is disheartening to note that. But anyway, every problem has a solution. The minute or the less toxic insecticide can solve that problem. Even otherwise, somebody said through the experience, it recovers. You will get new shoots coming. But you will not have the patience to sit and wait until the new shoot comes. So that is one of the problems that, you know, you will face. This is a common problem that I have noticed. And another thing, a grown-up tree, after 3-4 years, suddenly the leaves will be yellow. And then after some time, after a few days, the leaves will start falling and it will be dead. So kind of wood rot. I understand that it is a fungal infection or I think root. Yeah. So it can be a root problem. So that has to be treated. Actually, our people have to sort of... all the researchers and farmers have to have hands-on experience as to how to overcome that. It is not prevalent everywhere, but I have had the experience in my own research. So somebody has to find, I mean, it's like this. It can be a fungal infection or it can be insect infection so that it could be treated, you know, there's no problem. And in agarwood, not only the stem, but also the root also get formation of raisin, right? Yeah. Roots also get the formation of raisins. That means not only stem. So don't just cut the tree and leave it. You have to check for produce in the roots also. And also I was informed by someone that if you leave about 30 centimeters or 45 centimeters and cut the tree, you will get new shoots coming up so that you can re-establish your crop and you select one or two good shoots and cut off, you know, the destroy the rest of the shoots. That is the best way to do it. That is another thing that, you know, sort of we have noticed. I'm talking only on key things and general things. Anything specific, you all can question after my speech as well as other scientists' speech. And now, with the experience of our Dr. Samsudin, also the experience of our department people, that government sector researchers and scientists, the process is a proven process. You don't need to worry. End of the day, all these tests were done and it is all proven. So you don't need to worry as to how it is going to be and you don't need to be negative about all this. Though I told you about pest and disease, I'm also telling you this because all are tested methods and it is all proven. You know, planting, it is not a major issue. But artificial inoculation is an issue. You have to be knowledgeable. You must have the correct fungus. and there are various methods of doing inoculation, and that could be done by trained people. You know, even Dr. Shamsuddin will be able to provide you with people, those who are capable of doing that job. Otherwise, we have enough of partners in progress. And someone also asked me, what if Mr. Shamsuddin changes mind that, you know, that he finds another lucrative business, or like, you know, he is no more interested. What will happen to the farmers? It is a reasonable and fair question, because it is true, it's not only the rich person, even the poor farmers wants to invest in this venture. And if he changes his mind, and what happens to all these trees, and what happens to all the investments that will go waste? That was somebody's worry. Definitely, there are smarter people born every day. You don't need to worry. There will be somebody who will take care of that. You believe in God, so there is somebody definitely. You don't need to worry about that. Always there is a smarter person. Right? There are so many partners here, investors here from different parts of the world. And like I said, it is a business that has been taking place for 400 years. You never looked at it. You know, it's only for 30 years, you know, it is being looked at in Kerala. And people from Assam realized that they have huge plantations, not small trees, huge trees. You need 4 or 5 people to hug the trees. So that sort of stock was there in existence, because they didn't know what to do with that. And they didn't know what it was. They didn't know how to make use of it. If you take our country, Sri Lanka, there are people, those who have cut the trees and destroyed, just put it to perish, for the reason they didn't know what to do with it. Usually, if you cut a tree, if it is not useful for any other purpose, it is used for firewood. And I met a young graduate at the quarantine office in Colombo. And she said she had 6 trees in her, you know, front yard. And the father cut all 6 trees. And they couldn't even use it for firewood because it smells. That is what she told me. Because it smells, they couldn't even use it for firewood. So what a, you know, pathetic statement that is. Because she had all the wealth to, you know, make use of. But unfortunately, like, I mean, her father cut it because she didn't know. So there are a lot of cases. Likewise, you know, maybe I'm sure even in Kerala, India also, you know, there would have been so many cases. They would have cut the tree, they would have cursed and said that, you know, it is useless. It is not even suitable for firewood. Because we don't know for what purpose we should use that. That was the reason. So, likewise, and I also understand that lot of people are skeptical as to, like, if you plant it, who will buy this? Who is going to market this? Who is going to commit? Definitely, Dr. Shamsuddin can help you. You, once you plant the trees, you can even sign an MOU, Memorandum of Understanding, where you have an agreement for buyback, right? Definitely, you know the arithmetics, how to work it out. And it is not a very long period like planting teak or mahogany. Teak plantations, you know, if you invest in, you need to wait for 25 years or 30 years. And if it is mahogany, you have to wait for 15 to 20 years. But in this, even sandalwood, you have to wait for very long years. If you compare sandalwood with agarwood, what a big difference. How much can you get? How much is a kilo of sandalwood? 1,000 rupees? Huh? Like how much? 7 to 8, yeah, 7 to 8,000 for sandalwood, 1 kilo. And what are you talking about, the price of agarwood? Unimaginable. You know, you can't imagine what you can get. It may be like, you know, from each tree, if you really cut it at the correct size and the age, definitely you can get millions. There is no second word about it. Only thing, there is a big responsibility for our scientists. Because all these years, naturally occurring product was harvested. Then for that, you have to wait for years. It can be 20 years, it can be 30 years. Sometimes with all that 30 years, you know, you don't get the matured product. That is because there was no attack of wood borers. So maybe Dr. Samsudin has to invite wood borers to do the job. Maybe there will be a way how you can induce wood borers to come around the tree and naturally infect. That is another way. Like, I mean, no, if you have, you know, we have been laughing about so many things in our life, which has become reality. So don't laugh, take it serious. This is food for thought. You can definitely do it, Dr. Samsudin. You are a man of enthusiasm. So definitely you can do it. Find the correct people, give the assignment, you will be successful. These are no jokes, you know, because this was naturally occurring thing in the past. Now you can see, did anybody think that you can artificially inoculate? Artificially you can introduce the fungus? Nobody thought of it, but it came to somebody's mind and it is workable. Earlier they said, you have to wait for 6 years minimum for the plant to mature and to introduce the fungus. But now we have seen with our own eyes at his resuscitation, at 3 years, he has got it infected. That means, you know, information is knowledge. This information is knowledge. You know, we can now, with a lot of guts, with a lot of confidence, we can talk, we can tell this. Because we ourselves saw it. He had got it done. So, what I am trying to emphasize is that the farmers, you don't worry so much about the negative side of the investment. Look at the positive side, because things have to change. It has to change for better, not for worse, right? In anything and everything you do, there are hurdles. We are there to solve it. There are people around who can help us. Knowledgeable people, we have enough of knowledgeable, educated people on this subject. We don't need to be a rocket scientist to plant agarwood. As long as you have the basic intelligence, the basic interest, that is more than enough. If you want to learn yourself, be a good listener, you can learn it. If you want to educate others, you learn to talk. You improve on your delivery. That's all you have to do. You don't need to be a rocket scientist. And one more thing that, you know, I like to emphasize. People say that you should... I have got 10 minutes, it seems so. Usually people say that you shouldn't be selfish. But my humble request to you, one should be selfish to the extent that you are not a burden to others. A person who has needs cannot serve the community or the surroundings, even the family. So, you should be selfish to the extent that you can look after yourself, if possible your family, if possible your neighbor, if possible your village, if possible your town. That means one has to be selfish to the extent that you are not a burden to others. That is the first thing you have to do, right? So only if you are well-to-do, you can look after somebody else. If you are a burden, then you are a liability for somebody else. So therefore, my humble request, be selfish. Don't be a burden to others. Help others whenever it's possible, wherever it's possible. For that you have to be selfish. You have to do well. For you to do well, this crop is an asset. Definitely it's an asset. You know, you have a lot of hopes. And especially, I would call upon the youngsters. If you look at people over here, more gray hairs than black hairs. But our interest, our experience should benefit the younger generation who would or who could invest in agarwood, because they have so many products out of agarwood and they have so many inventions. They even say not only it's giving positive energy, also they say it is for cancer cure and cancer care. So please look at all these beneficial things of this product, and if and when we are meeting, definitely half of you would have had some experience. I'm sure that you know you will have some experience, and you will have a lot of things to tell us, educate us, share your experience, very positive things as well as negative things, the mistakes that you made, you know, the findings that you got, all that will come out, which should benefit this industry. And the last thing I want to say, the soil of Kerala is the most suitable soil, I would say, because I was in Palakkad yesterday. I went to see Captain Jacob's land. So he is sitting on a, you know, gold mine, and he only has to plant the black gold. I call it black gold. And, you know, he can put his legs up in his retirement and enjoy life. So I was telling him, don't waste your time. You know, you go into this and get the benefit out of it. The soil is superb. You know, you have the water, you have the soil, suitable soil. So one thing, make sure that you don't get into trouble by planting on land that is waterlogged, because that is detrimental, and you know, you will kill the plant immediately. And also, whoever has big trees in your premises or you have access to big trees, try out the layering, what I told you, it will work very well. When you are doing air layering and when you clip the branch and when you are going to plant into the bag, planting bag, make sure the leaves are removed and too many branches are chopped off. So the best thing for that is when you do air layering of a big branch, when you are doing the layering for the big branch, parallelly you do the small branch also. So that in one branch you will have about 7-8 plants, different sizes. So you benefit by that also. Because in my experience, I wasted by clipping so many branches. But that is also a matured branch. So you can have different size by air layering. Then, you know, you are chopping off the branch, then you are multiplying your stock. So it will be very easy, and it has a biological age, like I said, which will benefit you, and the moment, you know, you plant on the ground, so that's going to grow fast. That's how I look at it. I hope my speech is not making you sleep. You all are investors. Even one tree is going to give you big return. Remember, you are scared, you don't want to take the risk, you don't want to go by others' word. You can have your own experience by planting one tree of agarwood. In 6 months' time, you know, you will see the difference. and definitely you will go for higher numbers. So I wish you good luck to all of you in this new venture, and all of us will be partners in progress. Thank you very much.